Hey there, welcome back to Clip Studio Paint Quick Tips. My name is Scott Drummond. I'm a comic artist and illustrator. In our last video, we went over the basics on how to use screen tones in Clip Studio Paint. But today we're gonna cover some more advanced techniques, like changing your screen tone patterns and coloring your screen tones. But hey, this is Quick Tips, so let's not waste any more time and jump right into it. All right, let's say you're drawing your favorite interdimensional insect person of some sort and want to add some screen tones. But there's a bunch of different textures that you want to use to represent different objects. Like maybe his hoodie is looking more like cloth, or his shirt has a striped pattern to it or something like that. Well, luckily that's really easy to do with some advanced screen tone settings. Just make your screen tones for his hoodie like you normally would. But once we click the screen tone effect, we're going to change the dot settings from circle to noise. Now the screen tone looks a little more random and natural, which could be a cool look for some cloth. We can make a new layer and do the same thing with his shirt. We can change the dot settings to line, then hit this small plus icon to open up even more settings. We could change the angle here to make the stripes go from side to side, and even use the frequency settings to make them thicker. We can even use a brush with transparency or an eraser to erase parts of the tone we don't want. Choose an eraser or any brush you have, and select the transparent swatch at the bottom of the toolbar. Now you can dig into the screen tones to give your drawing a little bit more dimension. Now, if you want to add color to your screen tones, that gets a little tricky. If we try to airbrush in a color and then make that a screen tone, it won't work right. So instead, we need to make a nice tone first. Then, for that tone's density, we'll set it to use brightness of image. If we leave it at use color of image, this won't work. Now we make a new color layer above our screen tone layer and right click on it or tap and hold on mobile. In the pop-up menu, go to layer settings and clip to layer below. Now our new layer is clipped to the screen tone layer, and any colors we put on it will only go over our screen tone dots. Now you can just fill it in, or even use an airbrush to go from one color to another. It's your drawing, go nuts! All right, hopefully that was helpful. If you've been enjoying these videos, make sure to like and subscribe to get more great tips. Thanks so much for watching. Now get out there and make some great comics.